Hi guys, so in this video we're going to be talking about the central nervous system. So the central nervous system includes the brain and the spinal cord. It also is made of neurons, which are basic nerve cells that conduct electrical impulses. They conduct this information electronically along a axon fiber, which is a long extension of the nerve cell body. So the nerve cell body kind of looks like there is like this, almost like a circle nerve cell with a nucleus, and then it has this axon body coming off, and then it has an axon terminal at the end, which are like little fingers sticking out. So information is sent along this axon body, is then sent out through the axon terminal, and then it's collected on the next nerve cell on the dendrites, which so like the nerve cells here with the nucleus, and it has little dendrites that come off of it. So you have the nerve cell with a nucleus and the dendrites with the axon tail and the axon terminal at the end. So the electrical impulse or electrical information comes in through the dendrites, through the nerve cell, along that axon, and then out through the axon terminal. Information is sent both electrically and chemically. If it's sent chemically, it's sent by something called neurotransmitters. So these little chemicals, what are called neurotransmitters, then stimulate that nerve. Okay, you can think about that with like medication or dopamine or things like that. So we're also going to talk about the peripheral nervous system. So the peripheral nervous system, I mean, you think, right? So central, brain and spinal cord, peripheral is outside of that. So it connects through the central nervous system. It consists of somatic, which are voluntary nerves, and automatic or involuntary nerves. So somatic movement occurs by an electrical signal sent from the brain to motor neurons in the body. So with somatic movement, it's movement that is voluntary. So like I'm gonna lift my hand up. That's somatic. So what is happening? So my brain is sending a signal to the motor neurons. The motor neurons are then sending the signal to my muscles saying, hey, I want you to lift that hand up. My hand gets lifted up through a neurotransmitter called acetylcholine. And acetylcholine is what is used to make my muscle contract or lift. So for this next portion, we're going to be talking about the brain. So different portions of the brain have different responsibilities and functions. Now, I love the brain, so I'm excited for this one. Okay, so we have our brain is composed into different lobes. So we have the frontal lobe in the front, we have the occipital lobe in the back, then we have the parietal lobe, which is on top, and then our temporal lobe is kind of like underneath in the middle, and our cerebellum is in the back at the bottom, and then we have the brainstem. Okay, so let's just start there. So frontal lobe. So our frontal lobe has to do with our movement, our reasoning, our personality, our behaviors, and our memories. So a lot of patients that might have trauma or injury to their frontal lobe, we see this a lot in psychiatry, they have a lot of like impulse control or behavioral issues can occur from that region. So the thing that's cool with the brain is when you have an injury to the brain, if you can locate where that injury is, you can understand certain behaviors or illnesses. Like if people are having trouble seeing, it could be damage to the occipital lobe. Like it's just so cool. Okay, sorry. So let's go on to the parietal lobe. So that's the one kind of in the top back. So the parietal lobe, this is our intelligence, our reasoning, telling right from left. Our language comes from the parietal lobe, sensation and reasoning. Our occipital lobe is in the back, and that's our vision. Our cerebellum is below that. So like the occipital cerebellum is below. That's going to be our balance, coordination, and fine motor control. And then we have our temporal lobe. That's one kind of like in the middle. This is our speech, behavior, memory, hearing, and emotions. And then our brainstem. Our brainstem controls our breathing, our blood pressure, our heartbeat, and our swallowing. So our frontal cortex really performs the most sophisticated functions of the brain. Our sensory and motor cortex, that is what we were talking about with motor function, with our central nervous system, So the motor function and the sensory system. So our sensory cortex and our motor cortex are very close together. Our frontal lobe does our planning, reasoning, imagining. So our frontal lobe is where decision making largely occurs, and that's why we do see the impulse control problems with people that do have injuries to their frontal lobe. And again, our brainstem controls our breathing, our swallowing, and our blood pressure. So if you see patients with an injury to their brainstem, you've got to be watching for that breathing and the blood pressure. That's why sometimes, like, people snap their necks and they die. That's what it is. You're not breathing, you're not having good blood pressure, brainstem. All right, and that is it for the brain. You want that free 14-page ATI study guide, make sure to grab one down below. If you want the full ATI TEAS science study guide, you can go ahead and click that link below as well, and it will bring you over to where you can purchase. Okay, thanks guys. Thank you.